when an employer has an incident, the first thing the employer needs to do is take care of the employee and assess what the degree of the accident is. So if it's a head injury, a fracture, you know, something along that line, they need to seek emergency room care, get that treatment taken care of with that employee. If it's not, if it's an injury where it's a strain or sprain or something along that line, then at that point in time, the employer has a little bit more time. They can go ahead and assess the injury, move on, and decide what kind of care. In the state of Missouri, the employer has the right to direct medical care. The employee can seek care on their own, but it's at their own expense. But the employer does have the right to direct care, and that is a huge benefit under the Missouri law. So employers should take advantage of that. They should make sure that they're reporting a claim timely, but also getting that medical direction and get it to where they need to seek care. So employers really need to have a medical provider that they work with, an urgent care, maybe an occupational medicine physician if there's one available in the area, and then send that employee for that initial medical care. The next thing you really need to do as an employer is a thorough and complete accident investigation. And I hope most of our employers have written accident investigation procedures, because when somebody's injured, there's kind of the adrenaline going, the stress of the moment. So have an accident procedure in place, which means that you actually have written statements that are taken through witnesses, the employee, that you actually look for photos and videos. So if there's a photo of an accident site, you know, you want to take it back a ways, but then you want to also take a photo up close so that you realize what's going on. It also preserves the scene for that day. So our field service managers go out and we do accident investigations. And today it's a beautiful day. Tomorrow it could be raining when we went out and did an accident investigation. That's an entire different scene than what had happened on the day of the actual injury. The other thing is to look for videos, because right now you don't realize how many times we're on video when we're just doing our everyday lives. The video does tend to record over itself, so you want to make sure that you get video quickly and timely. And I tell a lot of my accounts, you know, use your iPhone. That iPhone is a way to record it right off of the other video if you can get it. So get that information. Again, make sure you have an accident investigation procedure in writing. And you can get those forms, if you're interested, at Missouri Employers Mutual's website, mem-ins.com. The other thing is to really have good procedures to look at how that accident happened, why it happened, and what we say is the who, what, when, where, and why. And look to how do you prevent that in the future so you don't have a repeat claim. We really want to avoid those type of claims. You know, I go out and do a lot of accident investigations, and typically even on a fall, I'll hear, well, someone fell there before, but they didn't get injured, so nothing was fixed. Try to keep those injuries from happening if you can. That's the number one way to do it. But the next thing to do when you actually have an incident is to do an accident investigation, get it reported timely, get a drug and alcohol test if that is available and if that's something that's in your policies, and look to light duty return to work. How do you get that person back to work, and how do you get them back timely? And then refer to MEM for our expert advice, and we'll help you with managing that claim.